गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू? कैसे हैं बेटे आप सभी? यू आर ऑल वेलकम इन आवर टुडे सेशन। आई दिनेश मेघलानी वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन योर वेबसाइट www.examtv.in एज वेल एज यूर यूट्यूब चैनल दिनेश मेघलानी ट्यूटोरियल्स। दिस इज आवर सीरीज ऑफ सेशंस ऑन द डिफिकल्ट प्रॉब्लम्स फॉर कैट एंड जेट एग्जामिनेशन। वेरी हेल्पफुल for the students who are targeting MBA entrance examinations. Let us start with our session. If you are interested in buying our courses, our number is given on the screen. You can call or WhatsApp on this number for getting courses for CAT, MBA, IPM and SSC. Let us start with our first statement. Right now, what is given in this question? Just try to observe. It's given that there are two numbers A and B are inversely proportional to each other. Here the point is that they are inversely proportional. If A increases by 100%, it means A is to be made twice. When I say A is to be increased by 100%, it means it has to be made twice. Since they are inversely proportional, it means B has to be made half. But only in that case we can say they are inversely proportional, because if they are directly proportional, the percentage change must be same. ठीक है, since they are inversely proportional, if I say that A is to be made twice, then B have to be made to be half. It means B is to be decreased by 50%, right? Hence I can say first one is my answer. Since my question is then B decreases by, so I can say that B decreases by half. It means B is to be decreased by 50%. A becomes my answer, right? So it's a basic question of directly proportional and inversely proportional. Let's take the second statement here. That's based on the concept of the remainder theorem. Since it's a practice session, so we are going to solve the different types of questions. So what is expected? If you have not watched our concept classes, so you can either watch on our YouTube channel, some videos we have uploaded, or you can buy our course by calling on this number or visiting to our website examtv.in. Let us try to answer this problem. What is the remainder? Okay, so we just try to find individual, like 19 raised to power 20 divided by 7. I have to find the remainder, right? So what I can say, I just try to make the pair 7 threes are 21. It means minus 2 raised to power 20 divided by 7. Here I can say that would be 2 raised to power 20 divided by 7. Now I just try to make an combination of 2 and 7. So I know that 2 cube, that is equal to 8. ठीक है, इट विल गो ऑन 6 एंड आई कैन से दैट इज 2 स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय 7. व्हाई आई हैव डन दिस? टू गेट रिमाइंडर टू बी आइदर 1 और -1, राइट? सिंस 2 क्यूब इज 8, तो 8 रेज टू पावर 6 इंटू 4 बाय 7. व्हेन आई डिवाइड 8 बाय 7, माय रिमाइंडर इज 1, तो 1 इंटू 4 रिमाइंडर इज 4. तो व्हाट आई कैन से, व्हेन आई जस्ट डिवाइड दिस एक्सप्रेशन बाय 7, रिमाइंडर इज 4. Now I just try to find for 20 raised to power 19 divided by 7. We'll try to find the remainder. 7 threes are 21. It means remainder is -1 raised to power 19 by 7. -1 power is odd. It means my remainder is -1. Okay. Now what I can say, when I divide this 19 raised to power 20 by 7, my remainder is 4. And if I divide 20 raised to power 19 by 7, my remainder is -1. Since here minus sign is there, so minus minus plus 4 plus 1, I can say that my overall remainder would be 5. So you can say A is your answer. It's a very elementary question. The concept, here I just applied the concept that I taught you in our theory sessions of the topic of remainder theorem, which is a part of the number system. There elaborately I have explained you the whole concept. Here I just applied that approach for answering our problem. Okay. I hope up to this point is clear. Let us move to the next statement. Just try to observe it. In the mathematics, it's very important for us to observe the statements because in the CAT examination specifically, as well as in the ZET examination, the language is typical. A gold ingot is in the shape of a cylinder, is melted and resulting molten metal molded into a few identical conical ingots, right? Means we have a cylinder and that is to be melted into the conical ingots. Height of each cone is half of the height of the original cylinder. It means if I say height of the cylinder is 1, the height of the cone would be 1 by 2. That I can say, I can compare the heights. Then it's given that an area of the circular base of each of the cone is 1/5 of the circular base of the cylinder. You know that volume of the cylinder is pi r square h and volume of the cone is 1 by 3 pi r square into h. It means height can be compared. This pi r square, that is the base area, right? It's given that the cone base area is 1 by 5. It means if I say cylinder base area is 1, it means cone base area would be 1 by 5. And this is 1 by 3 additionally for the formula. So that I can compare for finding the number of conical ingots that I can make. Just simplify this. That would be 1 divided by 1 upon 30. 30 will go in numerator, 30, right? So you can say that E is your answer, that is 30. So number of conical ingots that you get, that would be equal to 30. Very basic question. You have just compared the volume. Since this is the volume of the cylinder and I have to find out how many conical ingots I can make, so I just divide this by the volume of the cone, right? And from there I can find out how many conical ingots can be made. So here answer to my problem is 30. E is our answer. Okay, let's take the next problem. What is given in this statement? Two lighthouses are located at a point A and B on the earth, 60 feet and 40 feet tall, respectively. Each lighthouse is perfectly vertical, and land connecting AB is perfectly flat. Like it's like this. One lighthouse, second lighthouse, right? This is like this. This is A, this is B, this height is 60, and this height is 40 feet. The topmost point of the lighthouse at A is A dash, this is A dash, and this is B dash according to question. Draw the line segment A dash B. I have to meet this line, and I have to meet this line, okay? And they are intersecting at a point C dash. Draw a perpendicular here, that is C. माई क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड सी सी डैश. ये हमारा स्टेटमेंट है, ठीक है? अब देखो बिल्कुल सिंपल सा होता है. ये एक स्टैंडर्ड सा रिजल्ट है जो ज्योमेट्री मेंसुरेशन में आई टोल्ड यू इन अवर क्लासेस. सपोज एनी फिगर यू हैव लाइक दिस, ठीक है? आइदर दे आर वर्टिकल, मतलब दे मस्ट बी पैरेलल, द थ्री लाइन्स मस्ट बी पैरेलल. एंड वट रिलेशनशिप वी कैन बिल्ड बिटवीन दिस थ्री लाइन्स. लेट से द लेंथ ऑफ दिस लाइन इज ए, लेंथ ऑफ दिस इज बी, एंड दिस इज सी. ठीक है, तो यू कैन सिंपली से दैट सी इक्वल टू 1 अपॉन ए प्लस 1 अपॉन बी. दैट इज द बेसिक एसोसिएशन बिटवीन दीज थ्री लाइन्स. सी इक्वल टू 1 अपॉन ए प्लस 1 अपॉन बी, राइट? और यू कैन से दैट इज सॉरी दैट इज 1 अपॉन सी इक्वल टू 1 अपॉन ए प्लस 1 अपॉन बी. और यू कैन से दैट सी इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू ए बी डिवाइडेड बाय ए प्लस बी. यू हैव टू जस्ट रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूला. ऑल दो इट्स ए पार्ट ऑफ द सिमिलर ट्राइंगल, ठीक है? एंड प्रीवियस ईयर ऑल्सो नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चन हैव बीन आस्ड इन द कैट एग्जामिनेशन बेस्ड ऑन दिस कंसेप्ट. तो वट यू कैन से, सिंस आई हैव टू फाइंड सी सी डैश, तो सी सी डैश विल बी इक्वल टू 40 × 60 डिवाइडेड बाय 40 + 60, राइट? तो दैट वुड बी 2400 डिवाइडेड बाय 100. तो आंसर टू माई क्वेश्चन विल बी 24. सी इज माई आंसर, ठीक है? तो वट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर हेयर, एट एनी मोमेंट इफ यू हैव एनी फिगर ऑफ दिस टाइप, ठीक है, आपको बस ये ध्यान देना है कि ये लाइन्स पैरेलल होनी चाहिए आपस में, ठीक ठीक है, अगर ये लाइंस आपस में पैरेलल हैं तो विदाउट एनी प्रॉब्लम यू कैन से दैट योर आंसर इज सेट टू बी, यू कैन अप्लाई दिस कॉन्सेप्ट, वन अपॉन सी इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन ए प्लस वन अपॉन बी, और यू कैन से दैट सी इक्वल टू ए बी बाय ए प्लस बी, तो आंसर वुड बी 24. ओके, नेक्स्ट स्टेटमेंट, वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन ऑफ फंक्शंस, ए डॉट बी इज इक्वल टू दिस वन, यू हैव टू फाइंड दिस वैल्यू. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी सॉल्व दिस, दैट वुड बी 5 प्लस 2 इंटू 2, तो दैट वुड बी 7 इंटू 2 14. नाउ आई सॉल्व दिस, दिस इज 14, तो दैट इज 14 प्लस 5 इंटू 5, तो 19 इंटू 5 दैट इज 95. ओके, तो आंसर टू माई क्वेश्चन इज ए, द रिजल्ट ऑफ दिस वैल्यू वुड बी इक्वल टू 95, तो 95 इज माई आंसर. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट दिस क्वेश्चन स्टेट्स यू, व्हेन एक्सप्रेस्ड इनटू द डेसिमल फॉर्म, व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग नंबर विल बी नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग एंड नॉन रिपीटिंग. तो यू नो दैट इन द नंबर सिस्टम यू हैव डन नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग एंड नॉन रिपीटिंग वुड बी इरेशनल नंबर. तो आई हैव टू जस्ट चेक आउट ऑफ द गिवन फोर ऑप्शन, गिवन फाइव ऑप्शन, विच ऑप्शन इज एन इरेशनल नंबर. ओके, तो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद टेकिंग ऑल द ऑप्शन वन बाय वन. इफ आई चेक आउट ऑप्शन नंबर ए, it states me pi by 2, just simplify that, take the LCM pi, so that gives you 1 plus pi divided by pi minus pi by 2, so this is cancelled out, that would be 1 by 2 plus pi by 2 minus pi by 2, so this pi by 2 is going to be cancelled out, so 1 by 2, this is a rational number, means A is not my answer, correct. Then I shift to the second option B, साइन स्क्वायर 1 प्लस साइन स्क्वायर 2 डिग्री प्लस साइन स्क्वायर 89 डिग्री, राइट. तो व्हाट आई कैन से दैट, देखिए, वुड वी कैन सिंपली से साइन स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस साइन स्क्वायर 90 माइनस थीटा, साइन स्क्वायर 90 माइनस थीटा, तो दैट इज साइन स्क्वायर थीटा, एंड साइन 90 माइनस थीटा वुड बी कोस थीटा, दैट इज कोस स्क्वायर थीटा. दिस रिजल्ट इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू 1, इट मीन्स आई कैन से साइन स्क्वायर 1 प्लस साइन स्क्वायर 89 इज 1, साइन स्क्वायर 2 प्लस साइन स्क्वायर 88 इज 1. तो सिमिलरली व्हेन आई ऐड ऑल द वैल्यूज एंड इन द मिडल आई गेट साइन स्क्वायर 45, तो दैट वुड बी 1 बाय 2, तो इट मीन्स दिस इज ऑल्सो ए रैशनल नंबर, इट मीन्स दैट इज नॉट माई आंसर. देन आई शिफ्ट टू द सी ऑप्शन हेयर, क्यूब रूट ऑफ 729 दैट इज 9, राइट, so that is also not an irrational number. Then I check out option D, this is 4 minus pi, right, and it's infinite form, so you know about the infinite GP, so infinite GP is A upon 1 minus R, so here common ratio is pi by 4, just simplify that, so that gives you 4 minus pi, that is cancelled out, this value is 4. It means A, B, C, D, out of the options, none option is an irrational number. So E is your answer. So you can say that E is your answer, or you can just simplify here. When you simplify that, you get your term into the root term, right? So here, since you know that any fraction, any number that is non-terminating and non-repeating, that is an irrational number, and specific numbers you have irrational, like any number which is not a perfect square under root form, that is an irrational number. A number containing pi, that is an irrational number. Logarithm number is an irrational number. Exponential is an irrational number. So here, when you check out all the options, when we simplify all the options, you can say that answer is said to be E. E1 is an irrational number. Okay, let's move to the next question. Very important question from CAT and ZAT point of view. Just try to observe what's given here. Consider four variables A, B, C, D, and a function Z is given like this, right? A, B, C, D must be non-negative integers. You know that when you say non-negative means 0, 1, 2 and so on. And all are to be true. So Z is to be maximized. I have to find the value of T. Ab dekhiye, since you want to maximize Z, so Z can be maximized only when B is the minimum. Where B takes the least value, there Z can be maximized. Okay, since B sign is the negative and it's b raised to power 4, right? So whatever value b is there, b is to be minimum. Okay, now let's take the first equation, that is 2a plus b is less than equal to 2. Since I want to make b to be minimum, the minimum value of b can be 0. If b is 0, then a must be 1. If b is 0, then I can say that a is 1. Okay, that you can say. The two values we got, since I have to maximize that, so a is to maximize. So this simple relation I can get. Now, since I have to talk about d, I have to find the value of d. So d is given into the third one set, 3a plus 4b plus d less than equal to 15, right? A is 1, that is 3, this is 0 plus d less than 15. So d is to be less than equal to 12, right? My question is, what value must d take? So d must take 12. E is the answer, correct? Because value of d is to be less than equal to 12, right? So here I can say answer is said to be E. E becomes your answer. If z is to be maximized, so I have to find the maximum value of d. So maximum value of d possible in this question is 12. Okay, let's have the next question based on the basic percentages. Dekhi, what is given here? Nalini has received 600 WhatsApp messages from Anita, Bina, Chetra and Divya. Right, let's make it as A, B, C and D. Total messages are 600. And it's given that she from Bina she gets 30%. 30% means 180. And from Divya she gets 20%, that is 120, right? While Anita has sent equal number of messages as Chitra, it means out of 600, the 300 messages are already sent. So equal means that is 150 and 150, okay? Now it's given that, moreover, Nalini finds that Anita's, Bina's, Chitra's and Divya's messages are 60%, 40%, 80% and 50% are jokes. So jokes means 60% joke 90, 40% is 72, 80% of Chitra is 120 and 50% is 60, right? What percentage of the jokes received by Nalini has sent neither by Divya nor by Bina? It means I have to find that total jokes. So add all of the value, just add all of them. That is 2, 9, 7, 16, 22, and 12, that is 34. Total jokes are 342. So means not sent by Divya or Bina, it means they have to be sent by Anita and Chetra, right? That is 90 plus 120, 210 into 100, right? This value I have to solve, correct? And when I just solve it, I get value to be approximate to be 61.4%. So hence I can say B is my answer. So answer to my question is 61.4%. Very simple question, a basic question of the percentage, only for just calculations of the percentages. Okay, let's move to the next problem here. It's a question of functions, very important concept. This you can only do if you have watched our session in algebra on a number line method. If you have watched our session of number line method in inequality, so then in you can just answer this question very easily, right? How? Fx is given and it's given that fx is less than 0. So how to solve? You can just put all values equal to 0 to get your values to be minus 4, minus 6, minus 8, minus 98. Put all the values on the number line, minus 98, minus 96 and so on. So this is minus 4, then minus 6, then minus 8 and so on, right? Now what I told you in the number line method, you always start from here. It goes like this. And so on, right? So make it like this. It goes like this finally. So that is the process. Somewhere all the values would be there in the between. Now since my question is fx is less than 0, it means I have to take the negative parts. The negative part means this one, this one, this one, and these we have to include. तो फर्स्ट वैल्यू आई कैन से दैट बिटवीन माइनस फोर एंड माइनस सिक्स इट्स एन इंटीजर दैट इज माइनस फाइव. तो फर्स्ट वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स मस्ट बी माइनस फाइव, देन द सेकेंड वैल्यू मस्ट बी माइनस नाइन, देन इट इज माइनस थर्टीन एंड सो ऑन, राइट. तो आई हैव टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मेनी वैल्यूज आर पॉसिबल टिल दिस, तो दैट इज इक्वल टू माइनस 97. तो आई हैव टू जस्ट फाइंड आउट हाउ मेनी वैल्यूज आर पॉसिबल. तो यू हैव टू जस्ट कंपेयर फ्रॉम हेयर, ठीक है. तो आप यहां से इजिली काउंट कर सकते हैं. फर्स्ट वैल्यू इज माइनस फाइव, देन माइनस नाइन, देन माइनस थर्टीन, इट गोज अप टू माइनस 97. तो यू हैव टू जस्ट काउंट ऑल द वैल्यूज एंड यू आर एबल टू गेट योर आंसर. सिंस यू कैन से योर फर्स्ट टर्म वुड बी इक्वल टू माइनस फाइव, कॉमन डिफरेंस इज माइनस फोर एंड लास्ट टर्म इज माइनस सेवन. तो आई कैन से दैट ए प्लस एन माइनस वन, एन माइनस वन इंटू डी इक्वल टू माइनस 97. दिस कम्स हेयर, तो दैट इज माइनस 92. तो एन माइनस वन डिवाइडेड बाय माइनस फोर इज गोट ऑन 23. एन विल बी इक्वल टू 24. तो आई कैन से दैट इज माई आंसर. नंबर ऑफ इंटीजर्स एक्स फॉर विच एफ एक्स इज लेस देन जीरो, तो टोटल वैल्यूज दैट यू गेट फ्रॉम हेयर वुड बी इक्वल टू 24. तो 24 इज योर आंसर, राइट. मीन्स इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव मोर इनसाइट ओवर दिस टॉपिक, ऑन दिस टॉपिक आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू दैट फ्रॉम आवर कोर्स यू कैन वॉच आवर सेशन ऑन द नंबर लाइन दैट इज इन इनइक्वालिटी, राइट. और यू मैट फाइंड द वीडियो ऑन द यूट्यूब ऑल्सो, वी हैव ऑल्सो अपलोडेड, देर माइट बी सम वीडियो ऑन द इनइक्वालिटी. तो देयर आई एक्सप्लेन दिस कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. ओके, लेट्स हैव द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम हेयर. द क्वेश्चन स्टेट्स यू दैट एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स प्लस वन इक्वल टू जीरो. फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ एक्स रेज टू पावर 2018 प्लस एक्स रेज टू पावर 2019. दिस वैल्यू आई हैव टू फाइंड आउट. सिंस दिस इज गिवन टू मी, तो व्हाट आई कैन से, आई कैन सिंपली से एक्स स्क्वायर इक्वल टू माइनस एक्स माइनस वन, स्क्वायरिंग बोथ साइड, x raised to power 4 equal to x square plus 1 plus 2x. Since x square plus 1 equal to minus x, so I can say x raised to power 4 minus x plus 2x, or x raised to power 4 equal to x, or I can say x cube equal to 1. That I can infer from here. What I can infer from here, I can say that x cube will be equal to 1. Now, when I observe this statement, so what I can say, just try to simplify this. Since x cube is 1, to make it as x cube into, just try to identify on which number it goes. 3 6 are 18, 21 7 are 21, and 3 2 are 6. Means 2 is the remainder. And here, this goes on 3 raised to power 673. Since I know x cube is 1, it means that is that value will be equal to x square, and their x cube is 1, this value would be 1. So x square plus 1 is my answer, right? And since I know x square plus x plus 1 equal to 0, so you can say that x square plus 1 equal to minus x according to the information provided. So b is your answer. ठीक है, तो here you can say that on the information given here, you can simply say answer is said to be B. Correct? Okay, let's move further. This is a question of the number system. N is a number given that N equal to 11 raised to power P plus 7, 7 raised to power Q minus 2, 5 raised to power r plus 1 and 3 raised to power s. It's a perfect cube where p, q, r, s are positive integers. So we have to find smallest possible value of p plus q plus r plus s, right? Since I have to find the smallest possible value, to p plus 7, for making this number to be the perfect cube, power must be a multiple of 3. So minimum value of p is 2. Power must be a multiple of 3 or it can be 0 also, right? So here q can be 2, the minimum value of q possible is 2, आर इज ऑल्सो टू एंड एस इज थ्री. सिंस एस कैन नॉट बी जीरो तो वी कैन से दैट 6 + 3 = 9 इज माई आंसर. अकॉर्डिंग टू द गिवन इंफॉर्मेशन आई कैन से दैट द स्मॉलेस्ट वैल्यू ऑफ पी प्लस क्यू प्लस आर प्लस एस इज इक्वल टू 9 सो दैट द गिवन नंबर विल ऑलवेज बी ए परफेक्ट क्यूब. ओके लेट्स से वन मोर स्टेटमेंट. अर्थमेटिक एज वेल एज अलजेब्रा बोथ कंसेप्ट आर इंक्लूडेड इन दिस. इट्स अ वेरी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम कैट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. रानी बोट मोर एप्पल्स देन ऑरेंजेस. शी सेल्स एप्पल एट ए रेट ऑफ 23 ए पीस, मेक्स ए प्रॉफिट ऑफ 15%. राइट, तो इट मीन्स आई कैन फाइंड द कॉस्ट प्राइस फॉर एप्पल. सेलिंग प्राइस इज 23 एंड देर इज अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ 15%. द कॉस्ट मस्ट बी 20. यू कैन जस्ट अप्लाई द फॉर्मूला फॉर सी पी. राइट, यू कैन सिंपली से सेलिंग प्राइस इन टू 100 डिवाइडेड बाई 100 प्लस प्रॉफिट परसेंटेज, तो दैट वुड बी 20. दैट्स फॉर एप्पल. सिमिलरली फॉर ऑरेंज, सेलिंग प्राइस फॉर ऑरेंज इज 10 एंड देर इज अ प्रॉफिट ऑफ 25%, तो कॉस्ट वुड बी 8. दैट ऑल्सो यू कैन फाइंड बाई दिस वे. करेक्ट. नाउ माई क्वेश्चन इज शी गेट 653 आफ्टर सेलिंग ऑल द एप्पल्स एंड ऑरेंजेस. लेट से नंबर ऑफ एप्पल्स आर एक्स, नंबर ऑफ ऑरेंजेस आर वाई. तो टोटल सेलिंग प्राइस इज 653. इट मीन्स 23x प्लस 10y इक्वल टू 653. Now it's given that apples are more than oranges. X is more than Y. Correct. I have to find the values of X and Y. Right. Now we have to apply the concept of special equation. That's part of our algebra topic. If you have our course, so you might find their video on special equation. So there I explained you how to solve these type of concepts. Now I have to find the value of X and Y. Okay. So what I can do, I just try to find x and y. Let's say x equal to 653 minus 10y divided by 23. Right. Now it's your choice. Either you can go by x or you can go by y. Here it's easy for me if I go for finding the value of y. Right. How? Since I take y, so this is 653 minus 23x by 10. Both are integers. So when I put x equal to 1, so I get value of y. Put x equal to 1, 23. 653 minus 23, 630. Y would be 63. Now second value of x, how I can get? Since I am dividing by 10, just add 10. 11, then it would be 21. And similarly, if I take it for y, coefficient of x is minus 23, subtract minus 23. ठीक है, तो what you are expected to do, you have to subtract minus 23 here, that value would be 40, then it is 17. Since it's given x is greater than y, तो only this pair is possible, only this particular pair is possible. So now this is my selling price, I have to find the profit percentage, it means cost I have to find out. So cost would be 20x plus 8y. So 20 into 21, 420, and 8 into 17, right? That is 136. So I can say that cost price will be equal to 420 plus 136, that is 556. And selling price is 653. Okay, just apply the profit percentage. So when you solve it, you will get your answer to be B. Since there is a profit and profit is of rupees 97 divided by cost price into 100, that would be the profit percentage, right? So I can say that the profit would be equal to 17.4%. That's your answer. So B becomes your answer. Okay, let's move further. One more statement. AB equal to AC equal to CD. Angle ADB is 20. Since this is 20, this angle is 20, so this angle might be 20. This angle is also 20. Since the two sides are equal, Now suppose I say this is x, so this will be x. This is x, since these two sides are equal, x and x. Now x would be 40. Why? Because this is the external angle of this triangle, so this must be 40. So this is 40, this is 20, right? I have to find BAD. So BAD means total angle, I have to find 40 plus 20, 60. So 180 minus 60, angle BAD will be 120. So here I can say that D is my answer. According to the information provided, angle BAD is equal to 120 degree. Next one is ABC and XYZ are equilateral triangles of side 54 centimeter. All smaller triangles ANM, QC, all triangles are equilateral. So that is only possible when we divide them equally, like this is 18, this side would be 18. So that become a regular hexagon. Theek, I have to find area of MNOPQRM. MNOPQRM, so that is a regular hexagon with side is 18. So you know that area of the hexagon is root 3 by 4 into a square into 6. Means it's a combination of 6 equilateral triangles. So root 3 by 4, a is 18. 18 into 18 into 6. 2 will go on 2, 2 will go on 9, 2 will go on 9. So 81 into 6 root 3, 848, 486 root 3, so hence I can say B is my answer. So what you can say that, if you just observe this problem, so here you can say that your answer is said to be B, area of this shape MNOPQRM would be 486 root 3 square centimeter, that's your answer, correct? So this is end to our session. I hope you enjoyed it. That's primarily for the students preparing for CAT, MBA entrance, IP MAT as well as SSC examination. Since for CAT, MBA and IPM examination, the whole syllabus is into the English medium. So that's why here we try to maintain English medium here so that the students can easily understand. If you are interested in buying our courses, our website is www.dineshmiglani.com as well as examtv.com in our YouTube channel Dinesh Miglani Tutorials. For any query regarding courses, you can call or WhatsApp on this number 9215154 35. At a very affordable price, we offer the courses. For CAT, it's just rupees 3000 rupees, including your topic test as well as the sectional test in the online mode. Thank you very much.